हेलो एवरीवन, माय सेल्फ नारायण पवार, एचओडी ऑफ इलेक्ट्रिकल डिपार्टमेंट एट प्रवीण पाटिल कॉलेज ऑफ डिप्लोमा इंजीनियरिंग एंड टेक्नोलॉजी पाइंदर, डिपार्टमेंट इलेक्ट्रिकल इंजीनियरिंग, सब्जेक्ट इलेक्ट्रिकल सबस्टेशन प्रैक्टिसेस, सब्जेक्ट कोड इज 22633, सेमिस्टर 6। So students, today we have to see the maintenance of the GIS. Maintenance of GIS. GIS is nothing but gas insulated substation. So the main component are used is SF6. SF6 is nothing but sulfur hexafluoride gas filled enclosure and made up of the metal and are properly earth maintenance in comparison with the air insulated substation as very less. Only switching or moving parts are the required in periodical maintenance. This is the main things of maintenance of the gas insulated substation. Now we have to see the some points of maintenance of the gas insulated substation. Internal of maintenance means which parts we have to check and then maintenance and inspection of the part. So first, every 12 months, so we have to check the load break switches and circuit breaker. So these things checking within every 12 months. And maintenance and inspection, we have to reading of the operation of the counter, then functioning of the heating in operating mechanism. So these are the inspection are the take place within every 12 months. So we have to check the load break switches and circuit breaker with every 12 months and reading of the operation of the counter, then functioning of the heating in operating mechanism. So this is the first maintenance things of gas insulated substation. Next, After every 5 years, we have to check the circuit breaker as well as the load break switches. It may be connected or the disconnector. So we have to check the isolator also. Then earthing switches. We have to check the SF6 gas, sulfur hexafluoride gas systems. So we have to check these things with every 5 years. So which maintenance things are the required and which inspection you will be do. So trial of on and off position of the device. So means we can easily check the continuity of the supply. It may be the workable or not work. So we have to trial of on and off operation. Next, tip dash pot of the oil level. Means we have to check the oil level is the proper or the not. So we have to check the oil level of the gas insulated substation. Then we have to maintenance and inspection of the motor running time contacts through the inspection glass. So motor are proper running or the not, we have to check with the maintenance time. Then motor running times, it is having to the proper running times or the not, time increasing or the decreasing. So we can easily inspection with the maintenance of gas insulated substation. Then pressure of the gas, it may be the proper or the not. Inside the gas insulated substation, the pressure is near about 3 kgf per centimeter square. At that pressure, gas insulated substation work. So we have to measure the pressure. Then next inspection is that moisture content of the gas switching point of the devices. Means it have the some moisture, then we have to clean the gas insulated substation. So these are the some maintenance and inspection of the gas insulated substation. So trial on and off operation, tip dash point of the oil level, motor running times contact through the inspection glasses, motor running within a time or the not, we have to check this. Then we have to check the gas pressure. It may be the 3 kgf per centimeter square. Then moisture content of the gas switching point. So these things are required for the maintenance as well as inspection of the gas insulated substation. Next, for every 10 years, we have to check the circuit breaker. Okay, circuit breaker have to check every 12 months, every 5 years and every 10 years. So circuit breaker is the main device of gas insulated substation. Circuit breaker is nothing but which make or break the circuit under normal and abnormal condition. Under normal means during the normal condition or the fault condition. As during the normal condition, it carry the continuity of the supply, and during the abnormal condition or the fault condition, it discontinuity of the supply is the take place with the help of circuit breaker. So we have to check the circuit breaker every 12 months, every 5 years and every 10 years if it is proper or not. So these are the main maintenance and inspection of the gas insulated substation. Next, we have to see the which things you have to do and don't for the substation operators. Means some points of the here given for the do and does not. They observe out the carefully, and then electric shock and accident can be easily avoided. So we have to see the do and don't for the substation operation. Means then electric shocks and accident can be easily avoided. Okay, so first we have to see the which things we have to do and which things we have to don't do. Okay, so first which things we have to do, place sign means the main working or other wiring boards on the main switch before the work in the substation. Okay, means we have to make the proper sign. If the main working in the substation, then we have to wearing the boards and proper closing and sign indication may be the take place. As the place the sign main working or other wiring boards to the main switches and the commencing the work board. So this is the main things we have to do, means place the sign main working and other warning board on the main switches before the commencing of the work. If we have to enter inside the substation, then we have to make notice to the operator for the warning boards as well as the main working. So these things we have to do, and which things we have to don't do. Okay, do not close any switch. That is main things. Do not close any switch unless you are familiar with the circuit, which is the control and known the reason for the being open. Okay, so we have to don't touch any parts of the substation in case we enter in that substation. That is the things. Next, before working on any circuit or the apparatus, make sure that the controlling switches are open and lock or the fuse holder withdraw. That is the main points. Means before working on the any circuit or the apparatus, make sure that the controlling switches are open and lock the fuse holder within a withdraw. So these things we have to do. Next, don't touches or tamper with any electrical gears or the conductor. Don't touches or tamper with the any electrical gear or the conductor unless you have made sure that it is dead and earth. High voltage apparatus may give the leakage shock or flash over even without touching. So this is things we have to always remember. Next, which things we have to do? Always treat the circuit as alive until you have to prove them to be dead. The insulation and the conductor may be defective. So this is things we have to observe. Next, do not work in the live circuit without the express order of the person in the charge. Means do not work in the circuit without express the order of person in charge. Make certain that the safety precaution have been taken and you are comfortable with the all equipments. So these things we have to avoid. Then the habit of the turning your face always whenever an arc flash may be occur. Do not disconnect the earthing connection or the ineffective the safety gadgets installed in main air apparatus. Guard against the arc as well as the high voltage, and remember that the bounce from the arc may be very safe. Do not tamper or do not touch with the meter board and cut out it unless you are authorized to do work. See that all the splice and connection are surely connected or the do not express your eyes to an electric arc. Painful injury may result even with the short circuit. So these are the some points which we have to observe, means which things we have to do and which things we have to avoid before enter inside the substation and after enter inside the substation. Means we have to wear the proper gloves and shoes. Then we have to wear the helmet. Don't touches the live wire. Don't touches the electric board. So these things are the essential. In case the any conductor may be the break, then immediately inform to the operator. So these things are essential for electrical substation, and we have to always remember which help to provide the electrical substation, to provide the electrical apparatus, to provide the electrical equipment. So in case of the any conductor may be the break, we have to immediately inform to the operator and to avoid the electric shock. So this is the main points of electrical substation. Here the maintenance things is also essential. We have to maintain the and inspection of each and every parts. So maintenance of circuit breaker inside the gas insulated substation is essential. So maintenance of the load break switches and circuit breaker for every 12 months. So inspection of the reading of the operation of the counter, functioning of the heating in operating mechanism, for maintenance of the schedule of circuit breaker and load break switches disconnector, then earthing switches, sulfur hexafluoride gas systems. Then we have to trial on and off operation. This is the inspection or the maintenance of the gas insulated substation, means trial on and off operation. Tip dashboard, the oil level, means we have to check the oil level of the gas insulated substation. Then motor running times contact through the inspection glass. Motor running within a times or the not, we have to observe it. We have to check the gas pressure. It may be 3 kgf per centimeter square. That gas pressure are required inside the gas insulated substation. Then moisture content of the gas switching and the point of the disconnect. Next, every 10 years we have to check checking the circuit breaker. Then trial operation on and off of the substation is essential. Then operating times measurement, this is also the essential things. So these are the main points of maintenance of the gas insulated substation. Why maintenance are the required? Maintenance are the required in electrical substation because the main component are the house in SF6 gas feed, totally enclosed, made up of the metal and properly earth maintenance in comparison with air insulated substation is very less. Only switching or the moving parts are the required for the periodic maintenance. Maintenance things increase the lifespan of electrical devices as well as the electrical substation. If we have to take the maintenance periodically, then we can easily maintain the each and every part. If we have to do the maintenance, then we have to also avoid the electric shock of that substation. Means obviously the lives of that electrical equipment is increases. If the lifespan increases, obviously the substation get the maximum effective. So these things are essential in electrical substation and practices. Thank you, students.